Joining us on Skype right now is University of San Diego Adjunct Assistant Theater Professor Corey Johnston. Corey, you have been working there since April 2nd. I think you took off a few hours for Easter. You've made more than 300 masks so far. Tell us about it. Tell us about the material that you've made. Where did you get the idea from, or how did you know how to make a mask?
Well, theater, I worked at the Old Globe and La Jolla Playhouse for a long time, so they taught me how to sew very, very quickly. But we had some stock. We had some stuff in stock. And when the announcement was made on Thursday night, I got in contact with my chair, and that person got in contact with the people at the university, and wham, on Friday, it started to happen. So I've been sewing now. I'm going to have it all told when it's all done, 487.
That's incredible. So, nearly 500 masks that now you're going to be able to, that you're giving out to people who really, people are really kind of scrambling to find some. So material are you using? I mean, are we talking about sequin stuff? Are there ruffles on them? What do these things look like?
No, they're just basic cotton.
Okay, cool.
I went through every single piece of cotton we have in our stock. So I'm just using those, and they're pretty basic, you know. So, and they have knit kind of strap ties. So I'm using what we've got. So,
Corey, you have a master's degree of fine arts in theater with an emphasis in costume design. But I bet you never imagined this is what you would be doing. I mean, you are now, helping our nation, helping our area in a pandemic.
Well, you know, theater has taught me a lot of stuff. And so there are so many of my friends who don't have the agency to be able to do anything. And so I'm doing it for them because I can. And if I wasn't doing this, I'd be going crazy.
What were you thinking? You were like, oh my God, I know where a great sewing machine is and some fabric, and I'm going to get started. Is that all it was?
That is exactly what it was. I knew that I had the space and I had some resources, and my shop is pretty small. I can't get more than one or two people in here, and I'm got the only sewing machines on campus. So I thought, I can't not do this.
I love this. This is incredible, Corey. So now, how are these masks going out? Because I know I read that you guys are going to be giving them to the people who are still working on campus. I mean, there are a lot of people that they still have to try to keep this thing running, even though students are not there.
Yeah, we're going to give them to our essential employees here first. And then after that, through Noel Norton in the College of Arts and Sciences and Mike Williams, the Changemaker Hub, we're going to pass them out to some of our community partners. So that'll be a good thing.
Did you have a template or something? I'm just wondering, what could you tell? Because I bet there are a lot of people who can sew around the city, and they're thinking, oh, I can't do it. I can't make that. I couldn't do something like that. What would you tell them?
Well, all you can do is try and fail fabulously and try again. anything is better than nothing at this point. And I used a pattern based off of what Kaiser Permanente was putting out. So I did what I could with that, and then I substituted some other materials. So, that's where I got my idea.
I like it. I can't tell. Is that a little bit of animal print on that one?
No, it's batik.
Oh, there you go. See? A costume designer. Corey, we really appreciate your efforts. People around the city really appreciate your efforts. Are you there? Are you working like 12-hour shifts?
Thankfully, not that many, but close to it.
I bet so. Is it kind of therapeutic in this time, maybe?
Oh, sewing can be really zen. Man, just sitting behind the sewing machine, it allows you to not think about anything else.
That's right.
So I love it.
And you're doing a good work. Corey Johnston, there in the theater department's costume room. We really appreciate you, Corey. Thank you for your story.
Thank you, Anna. Thank you so much.